12:12 p.m. Some of the housemates are in the living room.
Is Jodie chanting?
Dennis, Maggot, Michael and Pete are in the kitchen.
Jodie's got a chance. Michael, was it meant to make us feel afraid that she said we're all going to end up in her updated version of her book or her pamphlet?
So if you take the piss out of her, you're going to end up in a book?
Exactly.
She must think, particularly me, I'm fucking prick of the world.
You know, you're getting more Liverpool as the days go on.
I might have to ask to leave. I can't bear it anymore.
Oh, no, you're
having a laugh. I'm going to have to say something. It's painful. Anyway, there's porn channel writers pulling them apart and everything. Oh, the British public called me a slag. I'm losing my rag now. I've had enough. I've got a really short...
I thought you got on.
No, she thinks we get on. I'm cringing so much, I'm turning my head inside out. But I'm fascinated.
Well, you're keeping it together very well.
That's like an alcoholic going, yeah. Everyone says I'm an alcoholic and I'm going to go...
I pray for peace throughout the world and for the happiness of all humanity.
...12:59 p.m.
Okay. Kitchen foil, £2.07, yeah. 30 metres.
I prefer to wash my arse.
All of the housemates are in the living room compiling their shopping list. Pete and Geordie are talking about wearing fur.
I think it's really fucking low that you wear a fucking monkey coat.
Good.
I do.
Good.
I'll be honest with you, I do.
Good.
And it offends me every time I see it on your back.
I get off on the fact that my monkey fur coat offends you. You do the math.
It's only when people like you...
You think if people
think
don't wear fur, they don't stop.
Fur. No, it's if a everybody luxury took item. The same stance on it and went...
£1.68.
It's but wrong, they never right? Will. It's murder, it's that's wrong, mean. It's
they
absolute...
never will.
Do you think then fur wouldn't... all animals is murder?
That's yeah.
A very strong word, murder.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, so we're all murderers, those of us who are we're about to eat chicken and steak tonight. We're all murderers, are we?
Right. Please don't get on my back as well.
No, you...
I really don't want this.
No, but
all I want... all I'm going to say on this is I will never sit and preach to you about eating meat. I will never, OK?
No,
I do
no,
think
no.
It's murder.
So, see, you're not going to preach about it, but we're murderers.
I didn't call him a murderer. I didn't call him a murderer. I said animals are being murdered for their fur.
No, you said someone murdered my fur for me.
Yeah, because you're wearing it.
So what am I supposed to do? Let a perfectly beautiful thing go to waste?
If someone chopped you up now and peeled all your skin off, I
would
be beautiful.
Think
that was beautiful.
Well, I actually hope that when I'm dead, somebody stuffs me and puts me in a living room.
Oh, OK. I don't want that, personally.
I would like to be embalmed and put on display prominently.
You get your head mounted on a wall.
Absolutely.
Well, that's
I'm all for
very
it.
Very wonderful, but yeah, I personally wouldn't like to see that.
But it's all about freedom of choice, isn't it?
Eskimos live in the frozen north. There's nothing they can wear except the furs of animals. They're not murderers. They're human beings who have to
why
wear fur coats.
Why do they live so primitively, then? Why do they not have what
well,
we have today?
Frankly,
why do they not
frankly,
have shops and...
I'm not sure you're the best person to lecture the Eskimo on living primitively. Having heard from you, your own mouth, the kind of life you live, I'm not sure that an Eskimo can be described by you as primitive. I'm
a quite well, right. They don't have shops and they don't have
quite right.
Computers and they don't have
no.
They choose to live like that. So
they choose to live like that.
But what the hell has this got to do with me?
You dive in there
because you're throwing out words like murderers and primitive.
I didn't call anyone a murderer.
You
George.
Did. You said
I said animals are being murdered for their fur. Did I call you a murderer personally? Did I? Did I? Answer me that. And you, answer me that.
No, I
I'm
asked
sorry,
you.
I
said
are...
to you, is the killing of all animals murder? And you said yes.
Because
I think
more,
it is.
You said
that,
I'm
well, that means that those of us who
no,
kill
I'm
animals
I'm
with your bare
hands. Me, and I can't.
No, but I'm eating
bear.
What
no,
someone
don't,
else
so
kills.
I didn't call you a murderer.
Well,
I will swear that to you on my mother's life.
Hello, bananas are 15p each.
Yeah, but they'll go off.
I just don't think you think hard enough about what you say
anyway,
and you don't think hard
anything.
Enough about what you do and then you get very hurt by even a sort of heated debate. You get very upset.
No, I get hurt. I'm hurt about this because I do feel like I'm being singled out by a few
exactly.
people here.
You put something out
I'm
there for opinion.
No, I'm hurt that I'm being singled out in the first
do you
place
think,
and that I'm
do you
being
think the people? All right, honey. All right, let's really get down to it now. What do you think? If she's got nothing better to do, what do you think Jordan was thinking last night when you were saying she had a nose like an ugly old witch from the side?
Anybody who's interested in ordering our food, should
like.
We go
I
in there? Because
the
this
side,
is impossible.
Her nose is hooked. It looks like a wick. Definitely.
It's true. Jordan's going to sit at home and have the last say. You should never have passed comments. Conduct yourself with dignity.
I'm sorry that whatever I say comes out of my mouth.
It is you who's sorry, because you'll be hurt when you go out.
No, I won't. I'm hurt right now because you're all picking on me. And you know what? None of yous are perfect either. None of
yous. Who said we were?
So shut it.
Two or three p.m. Chantelle, Geordie and Maggot are in the bedroom. Most of the other housemates are in the living room.
She's a complete imbecile. Don't put yourself in the firing line if you can't take the bullet wounds.
But you're in here being vicious about her. She's in the other room.
You think that's vicious? I'm stating facts. I'm not being vicious. You think I say she's stupid? That makes me vicious?
Well, yeah.
No, she's really intelligent. She's highly intellectual. And I'm sure her book leaves Dostoevsky to shame. It's probably fabulous. I haven't read it yet. She's harming herself on a public platform.
I have twice tried to say to her, look, we spoke on the first night that I came in here and you were really upset that people were booing you and you told me all the bad things they say about you. So use this opportunity to correct these things.
That's what she said she wants to do?
But in fact, she's used the opportunity to confirm and compound everything that people say about her.
She's got the mental capacity of a 9-year-old to me, and it's trapped in this body, and it's dangerous.
Perhaps with a lot of she's. I think
she's more intelligent than you give her credit.
She's extremely calculating with this act of crying on everyone's ass about a talent. Oh God, my pain.
But the most
pain.
Intelligent people can burst into tears when they get frustrated. Do you know what I mean?
Just give me a fair chance. Stop asking.
You want everyone to be nice to each other.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, I do feel like I'm being a bit picked on at the moment, and I do feel like I'll probably be nominated first now because I feel like all of them in there just hate me. And I'm not. That's not being dramatic or negative. I honestly feel like they're.
That's your true feelings. Yeah.
Like that's my true feelings. I feel like they really dislike me, and they have done from the minute I walked in here. They didn't look at me like a human being to get to know and what I could offer them in terms of laughter and fun and. Jokes and do you know what I mean? The point is, they're all getting on my back for being negative when they're not being nice to me and they're not being positive to me and they're not asking me anything positive. And now I just feel like I'm kicking up this big storm in here just for being me and just for answering a fucking question, honestly. Take it! You ain't never gonna be Prime Minister. So, there's a very good reason you're in Big Brother and Tony Blair's not. You get me? You get me? Very good reason that you is here and he is out there ruling our country. Yeah?
...2:40 p.m. Maggot, Ruler and George are at the dining table.
She's saying that people are not talking to her about positive things, they're concentrating on the negatives.
That's why I tried to get it to Chandler, because if you put out negative all the time, you invite negative back. Her beef is very one-dimensional at the moment, and it's against one specific person. And she perpetuates that argument all the time.
Geordie is in the diary room talking to Big Brother.
Are you okay, Geordie?
Yeah. I just think George is vile. I just think he's a bitter old man that hasn't got time for me or Chantelle or anybody else like that because in his eyes we're beneath him. Totally beneath him. George thinks he's something either more special or more intelligent or more wise than what perhaps I am. I don't think he's a particularly nice person. He hasn't taken the time to get to know any of us properly. Maybe it is the reason that everybody else who looks down on me for is that for the last 3 years I've been portrayed to be something I'm not. And perhaps he's got that same image and from the minute I walked in here he probably just thought, oh, that's that bird that gets her tits out in the paper or whatever he thought, I don't know. Point is, he hasn't taken the time to get to know me at all. And the only time he's spoken to me for any length of time is just now to attack me. And I just think they're being unfair, as in Pete, George, Michael, because they keep banging on at me. And also feel like I'll probably be nominated first now, because I feel like everybody's looking at me like I'm some sort of annoying, moaning, negative old hag. And I'll probably be nominated first just for peace and quiet. No way do I want to be out of here first. That would be my most worst nightmare in the world, and I would be devastated. If I'm out first because of that, then I think that's really unfair, because I don't feel like I've been given a fair chance.